Students, we were doing the chapter Mahatma Gandhi and the Nationalist Movement. Students, we will start the topic, the Salt Satyagraha, the Civil Disobedience Movement. So we will see how this movement started. Here comes Fineman Commission. So in the beginning of the 1928, the British government sent a 7-member commission to India, which is known as Sir Simon Commission, after the name of its chairman, Sir John Commission. So the commission was appointed to go into the issue of further constitutional reforms in India, but all the 7 members of the commission were Englishmen. To Indian, it was a violation of the principle of self-determination, and they considered it to be an intentional hurting of their self-respect. So therefore, you can see almost all the political parties, they decided to completely boycott it. Gandhiji himself did not participate in this anti-Simon Commission movement, but he gave its blessing. So on Feb 3, 1928, the Simon Commission, they landed in Bombay, where it was greeted with Hartal and black flag demonstration under the slogan, Simon, go back. So in Lahore, Lala Lajpat Rai led an anti-Simon Commission demonstration on 30 October 1928. While leading the demonstration, he received severe lathi blow from Saunders, the British police officer, and you can see he was injured on 17 November 1928. The Simon Commission, its report failed to satisfy the Indians. Now comes the Lahore session and the complete India independence resolution. So on December 25, 1929, the historic 44th session of Indian National Congress was held at Lahore under the presidency of Jawaharlal Nehru. By this time, all the Congress leaders were convinced that the British government would not grant Swaraj to India till it was forced to do so. So it was during the session that a resolution for complete independence was passed on. December 31st, 1929, and the newly adopted tricolor flag of independence was hoisted. On January 26, 1930, First Independence Day was celebrated throughout the country, and Independence Day celebration was held at different places, with the national flag being hoisted and the patriotic songs being sung. So the Lahore session, it occupies a significant place in the history of the freedom struggle of India. So the election of Jawaharlal Nehru as president was a clear indication of passing of the baton of leadership to the younger generation. It also indicated that the new leaders who stood by the ideals of socialism and democracy were becoming very influential in the Congress. It was at this session that the Indian National Congress adopted the resolution of complete independence for the first time. The Congress decided to launch a civil disobedience movement to achieve its goal, and it was also decided that 26 January should be observed as an Independence Day every year throughout the country. It was during this session that Sun had succeeded the father Motilal Nehru and was the president of Congress session as the official head of the national movement. So here comes civil disobedience movement in the year 1930 to 1934 AD. Okay. So the condition in the country had become very favorable to launch a widespread movement against the British. Still, Gandhiji wanted to give a chance to the government before embarking on such a big movement. So, on 2 March, 2nd of March, 1930, he wrote a letter to the Governor General, Lord Irwin, detailing about the 11 demands. Of these, the important ones were reduction in the land revenue, abolitions of the salt tax and government monopoly over salt, reduction in the military expenditure, protection of Indian cotton textile industry, and release of political prisoners. So Gandhiji informed the Governor General that in case these demands were not met, he would launch the civil disobedience movement by violating the salt law on March 12, 1930. So why choosing salt as a symbol of protest? So the choice of soil as a symbol of protest against the colonial rule was a remarkable indicative of Gandhiji's tactical wisdom. Salt law was one of the most widely disliked law in the British India. It provided the state a monopoly in the manufacture and sale of salt. So the common folk, they hated the salt law. Salt law was an inseparable part of food for every household, but people were prohibited from making salt even for domestic use. It was because of this law that Indians were compelled to buy salt from shops at high prices. So the state monopoly over the salt was very unpopular. There was a strong discontentment among the masses against the salt law. So the state monopoly over salt had deprived the people of a valuable, easy village industry. So Gandhiji, by making the salt law as his target, wanted to garner the maximum participation of the masses in the national movement. So, as expected by Gandhiji, the Viceroy promptly responded to the letter, but his reply was highly disappointing. He decided to launch the civil disobedience movement. The movement was started with the famous Dandi March. So you can see on March 12, 1930, Gandhiji, along with his 78 of his followers, began his foot march from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi, a village on seashore in Surat district, about 375 kilometers away from Sabarmati Ashram. After walking, you can see, on foot for 24 days, Gandhiji arrived at Dandi on 5th April 1930. On the morning of the April 6th, Gandhiji, after saying his prayer, violated the salt law by picking the salt from the sea coast without paying any taxes. So he declared the British rule in India has brought about moral, material, cultural and spiritual ruinations of this country. I regard this rule as a curse. Our is a non-violent battle. We are not to kill anybody, but it is our dharma to see that the curse of this government is blotted out. So here comes the progress of, or the progress and the program of the movement. So the program of civil disobedience movement was to violate the salt law by manufacturing salt at various places in the country, to boycott the government, educational institutions and offices, burning of foreign clothes, you can see, plying takli and spinning cloth, non-payment of government taxes, resignation from their membership in councils and assemblies, and picketing of the liquor shops and foreign clothes dealers shop by women. And the progress of the movement, the violation of this salt law by Gandhiji was a signal of the beginning of civil disobedience movement. Soon this movement spread like a wildfire through, you can see, length and breadth of the country. So people started defying government law. The movement, like a forceful wave, it enveloped all places like Bombay, Bengal, United Provinces, Central Provinces, Madras, North West Frontier Provinces and Manipur and Nagaland in northeastern India. So forest law were defined in Maharashtra, Karnataka and central provinces, and in eastern India, even the rural people, they refused to pay chowkidari tax. Gandhiji called upon the women folk of the country to extend their cooperation to the movement. So in Delhi, some 1600 women, they picketed the liquor shops. The boycotting of foreign clothes, it proved to be very successful. In Bombay, 16 textile mills of English merchants had to be closed down. Large number of farmers were drawn into the movement. The movement was not limited only to the interior part of the country. The Pathan of Northwest frontier provinces under Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, popularly known as Frontier Gandhi, made a remarkable contribution to the movement with the organization known as Khudai Khidmatkar. In Peshawar, you can see Garhwali soldiers under Chandra Singh Garhwali refused to fire at non-violent agitators. In Nagaland, 13-year-old Rani Gaiduli, raised the banner of rebellion against the British rule. Dialogue significance of the salt satyagraha. So Gandhiji's salt march, it occupies a very significant place in the history of the freedom struggle of India because of several reasons. This march made Gandhiji a center of attraction of the whole of the world. The European press and the American press, they published detailed account of the salt march conducted by Gandhiji. Undoubtedly, it was the first national movement in which women participated in last number. Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay, the renowned socialist worker, advised Gandhiji not to keep the movement limited to men folk only. A large number of women, along with the Kamala Devi, violated the salt and liquor law and courted arrest collectively. As a result of the salt movement, the colonial rulers understood it clearly that their authority was not given to remain permanent in India, and now they will have to give some participation to the Indians in power. So here come dialogue, first round table conference and the second round table conference. So the British government, they called the first round table conference in London on November 12, 1930 to discuss the report of Simon Commission. So besides the representatives of the Indian states, representatives of Muslim League, Hindu Mahasabha and other political party of India also participated in it. Of them, Sir Tej Bahadur Saplu, B.S. Srinivas Shastri and Muhammad Ali Jinnah were the prominent. At this time, civil disobedience movement was at its height. Almost all the prominent leaders of the Congress were behind the bar, and the severe form of repression was being continued by the British bureaucracy. So Congress, which was the representative of 85% of the Indian population, they boycotted this conference. Consequently, this conference proved to be a failure. So the failure of the first round table conference made it clear that it was difficult to sort out any solution of this country problem in the absence of the representative of Indian National Congress. So efforts were made to bring about an agreement between the Congress and the government so that the Congress could participate in the second round table conference. On January 26, 1931, Gandhiji and members of the Congress Working Committee, they were released from the jail. On 5th March 1931, a compromise was negotiated between Viceroy, Lord Irwin and Gandhiji, which is better known as Gandhi-Irwin Pact. So according to this pact, the government agreed to release all political prisoners except those who were involved in the violent activities. So the government acceded to the right to manufacture salt for the domestic consumption and picketing of liquor and foreign clothes shop. In return, Congress agreed to suspend the civil disobedience movement and also agreed to participate in the second round table conference. So many of the Congress leader and particularly the younger section, they criticized Gandhiji for this pact. No doubt Gandhiji failed to get even a single important nationalist demand accepted by the government. So he failed to get reduce the death sentence of Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, Sukhdev to life imprisonment. But Gandhiji was satisfied as he believed that the pact had paved the way for, sorting out the Indian problems. In fact, Gandhiji wanted to provide opportunity to the rival party to change its policy by suspending civil disobedience movement in 1931. The Karachi Congress session of 1931, it validated the Gandhi-Irwin Pact. Here comes second round table conference. So the second round table conference was called in London on September 7, 1931. In this conference, Gandhiji participated as the sole representative of the Congress and Muhammad Ali Jinnah, that of the Muslim League. Gandhiji claimed that Indian National Congress was the representative by the whole of India. But his claim, it was challenged by the three parties. Here you can see the Muslim League, they claimed that it stood for the interest of the minority Muslims. The representatives of the princely state claimed that the Congress had no representation in their territories. Even B.R. Ambedkar, the brilliant lawyer and thinker, while challenging this claim of Gandhiji, declared that the Indian National Congress did not represent the lowest caste. So the Muslim League demanded a communal electorate system in the conference. The minorities and the untouchable, they too started demanding separate electorates and separate representations. So the second round table conference, it failed to make any significant decision. So the conference came to an end on 1st December 1931. And the disappointed Gandhiji returned India empty-handed.